Ladies and gentlemen, what a Monday! What a Fibonacci dance once again on S&P! What a crucial reminder to respect the end of the minor trend to the upside that S&P is struggling immensely to break through. What a crucial reminder what not to short into. First trade ended at this level, second trade we've taken from here, as I continue reminding you, bearish trend remains minor, do not short into this Fibonacci level. This trade struggling immensely, will it finally blast through with vengeance to drastically higher levels? 2052.50 is very crucial target on S&P. You can do it, S&P, go baby! Show us what you got. Show the importance of playing by Fibonacci rules no matter what we are in. If it's 2-minute S&P or if it's Apple monthly or if it's Tesla that's crashing and burning into oblivion. As I'm projecting that Tesla will be dancing at any time soon at very, very interesting 160 number. This is Tesla, traders. This is the reminder of reversal zone and why we said we are not buying S&P because it opened up a reversal zone, complete collapse on Tesla. S&P is rallying, woohoo! We knew that bearish trend remained minor, but this remains key level to the upside. Pretty please, trail very, very carefully. How much did we work? How much did we suffer this morning? Not much. And it's been officially one of the most torturous Mondays on record. What are you witnessing at reversal zone? Sellers stepping in? Are you surprised? Price came to reversal zone. This morning I continue warning you, do not acquire position into reversal zone. What you're seeing happening on Tesla is what's happening on S&P. It doesn't matter if it's Tesla, Schmesla, or it's S&P hourly. Only Fibonacci levels will give you accuracy you are looking for. Pay attention. This is hourly resistance. Are you surprised? Will price finally blast through this level and will continue on with bullish rally? As sellers confirm that bearish trend is minor, as sellers tested your knowledge of the crucial Fibonacci level time and time again? Go, baby. You can do it. Most torturous Monday on record. And once again, Fibonacci and price reminded you, magic happens if you play by the rules. It doesn't matter if you invest in long-term charts. It doesn't matter if you're a day trader. If you know how to use Fibonacci properly, that's when magic happens. And it does not matter what you trade. It's exact same formula I teach to complete beginner retail trader, and it's exact same formula I use when I work with hedge fund traders. When I identify long-term Fibonacci levels that show you where to enter, where to exit the trade. S&P came to reversal zone. Oh my goodness. Will it shock and burn and will it collapse? Just like Tesla had done? Just like FIT had done? Poor FIT. Spectacular earnings. Phenomenal. But reversal zone is reached. FIT is crashing and burning. Last time I looked on FIT last Friday, it was at 14. Oh no, fundamentals don't mean a thing, indicators don't mean a thing, the only thing that matters is Fibonacci. Fibonacci, as one of students had said, I should say I have PhD in Fibonacci, as it's been 8-year course that I developed for myself as I continue marvel at the markets, as I continue seeing how flawless Fibonacci puzzle this market is. And if you play by the rules, all you have to do is identify what's appropriate for you and your account size and your psychological comfort. What are you witnessing? How did we know to explain pain and torture here? Anybody surprised? That price is struggling immensely as trade came to key Fibonacci resistance reversal zone? Don't forget what happened on Fit despite spectacular earnings. Don't forget what happened on Tesla, where collapse started well before poor earnings release. All the same formula each and every time. If you know how to use Fibonacci properly, the sky's the limit. If you speculate about Fibonacci, or if you block your vision with indicators, nothing good is possible. So will the price respect this crucial Fibonacci support? Or will it crash and burn? As Tesla had done. I would love for the price to crash and burn, because if it does, market will become very interesting again. Market reminded you never acquire position into reversal zone. This is exact same formula as played out on S&P very powerful weekly chart where you witnessing sell-off in a progress. But to the downside, decision point to remain crucial. All the levels on weekly chart spelled out by the price since a year ago playing out today. Weekly chart respects reversal zone on S&P. As much as price respects reversal zone on this little day trading chart. The same exact fashion as Fit, as Tesla, as Apple, as Netflix are doing. As formula remains the same. What you trade is your choice. I warned you since last year. Short Apple when Apple came to 130. Exact same formula as baby chart S&P. I warned you when Netflix came to reversal zone since January 27th. Short Netflix spectacular earnings in April, ouch! As I said, since January, Netflix heading to much lower levels. That pure and that simple. And that's powerful confirmation. Indicators and fundamentals are background noise. The only thing that matters is Fibonacci and price action. If you master Fibonacci and price action, all you have to identify what you want to trade. That pure and that simple. So price reversed from reversal zone on S&P as expected. Exact same fashion as Apple Netflix. FIT in exact same fashion as Tesla had done. Reminding you, if you know the rules, all you have to do is identify if you want to be investor or you want to be day trader using key Fibonacci formula I developed. Any questions, always feel free to contact me. info@fibinstitute.com. I highly encourage you to mail or call me. I'm always available to answer your questions. 925-257-4298 or info@fibinstitute.com. Adjust your trail traders very, very closely. Will this time around, after brutal fight at the reversal zone, price will break through this level? Will be marvelous news.